Hello everyone, praise the Lord, very good morning. I'm happy that God has helped us to meet together on this wonderful morning. God has given us a new week and I believe this week will be a blessed week for us and every laborer of us shall be blessed by our Lord. And I hope you worship God with the family of church and you went to your church and you worship God over there. And it was a very pleasant moment and it was a very joyful moment to worship God in the presence of God, in the temple of God. We felt the presence of God in His temple. It was a very, very, very blessed thing. And we enjoyed it and we hope you also enjoyed it. God bless us. And our studio is under construction. We are changing some setups in the studio, so soon we'll be back as we do regularly. Today's meditation is from the book of Acts chapter 5 verse 8. Peter asked her, "Tell me, is this the price you and Ananias got for the land?" "Yes," she said, "that is the price." We know what is happening here, and Ananias and Sapphira, they both brought the money they got from the land and they brought it to the apostles. And before that, Ananias came and the apostle asked him, "Is this what you have sold?" And he said yes, and he died over there. Then the Sapphira comes. To her also the same question is asked. And she says, yes. All the other people also brought their money to the apostles. We could read that, but we do not read the apostles asked them such questions. But here, specifically, Apostle Peter is asking Sapphira, "Is this what you sold for?" And she said, "Yes, this is it. This is what I sold for." What does it tell to us? Apostle Peter particularly asked her, "Is this what you sold?" And even then, she was not convicted by the sin that she is committing. She did not think, "Oh, Apostle is asking such questions. Should I do that? I should repent." Because he is particularly asking it. He might have asked some other questions, but he particularly asked her, "Is this what you are doing?" She said, "Yes." My dear brothers and sisters, so many times when God rebukes us through His people, when God rebukes us through His word, we become dumb to listen to God. It does not affect us. It does not pinch us. It does not poke us. Why? Because we are familiar with the sin. We are comfortable with the sin. When we do it first, when we commit it first, it looks very, very ungrateful or very, very unpleasant in the sight of God. In the sight of us, it is always unpleasant in the sight of God. In the sight of us. So we regret about it. But when we start doing it again and again and again, we become familiar about it and we don't bother about the rebukes and the corrections that is from God. Even here, when Peter asked, he might have said unto Peter, "Oh my God, I have committed sin. Please forgive me. Please pray for me. I have committed a sin. Oh, Apostle, this is not what we have sold for. We have kept something. I will bring that also." She might have said that. But she was very comfortable with the sin she was committing. It is not about just lies. I am talking about all the disobedience about the word of God. May it be watching serials, watching movies, unwanted videos, spending time rather with friends or unwanted things rather than prayer and Bible reading, whichever is unpleasant in the sight of God. We are very comfortable with it. Even when God rebukes, we are not ready to turn back to Him. My dear brothers and sisters, It is true that everyone would fall, but I want to encourage you, when you fall, when God speaks to you, when God sends His word, rise up, get up and turn back to Him. Don't stay where you are. Don't be like her. Even when the question was asked, she never was able to turn back to God. But when we go away from God, when God rebukes, let's turn back to God. Let's not feel comfortable about the sin. God bless you.